Rams and Chi Professional Programs. Rams and Chi Professional Programs. Other than campus site located in Ganesa, ITB's campuses are also located in Jatinangor and Cirebon. 39 programs have been internationally accredited from accreditation boards around the world, namely from United States of America, ASEAN, Germany, Japan, United Kingdom, South Korea, and the number of accredited programs is expected to increase in the near future. ITB has been developing its cutting-edge research through the 102 research groups from 12 faculties and schools, 24 centers, 7 research centers, and 5 centers of excellence. To date, ITB has also established 104 startups, 315 intellectual property rights, and 137 innovations. In the spirit of In Harmonia Progressio, ITB alumni have worked and excelled in various fields and sectors. For instance, Insinyur Soekarno as the first President of the Republic of Indonesia, B.J. Habibie as the third President, Iskandar Ali Syahbana as the father of the communication system in Indonesia.
Institut Teknologi Bandung is an adaptive learning organization. In our over 100-year journey, ITB has a long standing as the leader in advancing science, technology, art, and social and humanities as well. ITB is striving to play a significant role in solving Indonesia's challenges while improving its capacity to compete globally. The alumni are our pride, who continue to share our values and significant contribution to the nation's development. To continue our tradition, we will always preserve a campus with academic atmosphere that is open to new ideas and experiences, critical and visionary thoughts, accompanied by attitudes that uphold academic freedom in scientific and cultural diversity. We are keen on continuously improving the quality of education, research, and community services, progressing in harmony, in harmonia progressio.
Okay, welcome everybody to the virtual tour that we're organizing with our colleagues from Wanderlust Indonesia. We are happy that you are here joining us. We're going to be waiting for a couple more minutes, until 10 past 2, GMT plus 7. And hopefully that more will be joining us in a little bit. But yes, so we're happy to have our colleagues, also our friends from the, we have Teh Fitria, we have Kang Jajat, Wu Neneng over here, and Mbak Marsa here, and my colleague in crime, Mbak Dini here, and from the International Relations Office, we also have Bu Nia and Bu Ciptani as well here with us. So we will be waiting for 2 more minutes and then we will get started. Hopefully that's okay for everyone. We expect that there's going to be about 24 people registering for the virtual tour, and this is also live streamed on YouTube. So we're excited that this is happening at all. Yeah. And this is actually marking the end of the semester at ITB at the university. And so hopefully for those of you who are about to go and to come to Indonesia, this is a glimpse of what you know, what you can experience, obviously, because it's not everything that you can experience. And hopefully with the you know, we're getting better in terms of the pandemic and the COVID-19 situation, and so you can experience firsthand you know, the village that we're going to virtually visit. And those of you who probably so we actually have Some who might be thinking about going to Indonesia, to ITB in particular, to ITB. So hopefully it also gives you a little bit of, you know, some idea. And perhaps we will talk about how long, yeah, Mbak Dini, how long we are, you know, how far or how long it will take from the campus in Bandung to the village in Cimahi. It's also to give you to give us some idea of, you know, how to get there, generally speaking, and how long you know, we can it takes to get there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I don't know how many of you in Bandung right now. Any of you in Bandung currently, or you're in your own country? Maybe. So can you change your just add like a country after your name in your account? Maybe that's gonna be a bit interesting for us to know, like, where all these participants coming from. Like, I think I know.
Okay. Yes.
Yeah, Farhanullah. I think change add like Pakistan in the end. So it will be great to see where all of you come from. But yeah, yes, Cirende is not that far actually, yeah, Mas Andika. It's in Cimahi, which is like the nearby the Bandung, and it's, I think it's only like half an hour or 45 minutes from ITB campus to reach this village. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yes, yes. So I would say that we can probably start. We're expecting that probably more will join us. As I mentioned, that we're expecting at least 24 people joining us, but we'll see that they're going to join us a little bit later, hopefully. And welcome again to everybody. And we're happy, we're excited that we are here in the session with our colleagues from Wanderlust Indonesia and our colleagues and friends also from the Cirende village in Cimahi, and our friends, our students or our future students of ITB. Welcome. My name is Andika Putra Pratama, and I'm the head of division for international partnerships in the Bureau of Partnerships, or usually we call it International Relations Office. And we have also our colleagues here who have been in touch with you as well. For some of you, probably, we have Bunia, Fatatu Sania Nur, and Bu Ciptani here under the name Kantor Biro Mitra and ITB. So without further ado, I welcome you, and let's enjoy the session in the midst of many things happening currently. Hopefully this is you know, a bit of a taste, yeah, of what's despite all the things that have happened or are happening at the moment. But we're hoping everybody's staying safe and something good coming in the future. Okay, with that, Mbak Dini, the floor is yours.
Okay, thank you, Pak Andika, for the brief intro about this event. And I would like to share my screen to all of you, so then you can see my screen right now. Yeah, welcome everyone to Kampung Adat Cirende. So pretend that you are in this village right now. Yeah, we are doing this virtual trip, yeah, virtual tour experience. This has been our pleasure to conduct this virtual experience with ITB. This is, I think, our third time or fourth time actually handling this virtual tour experience with ITB. And we're gonna be here until 4 p.m. maximum, so bear with us. Yeah, I don't know how late is it in your place, or how early, yeah, maybe in your place, because we are like all over the world right now. But if you just join, please, if you can add your country where you are from after your name, that will be great. So then we know where you are located. And if you can turn on your video, that will be great. So then the interaction will be more alive, yeah, in this virtual tour. And this is the gate that you will see, yeah, when you enter Cirende. It's called Wilujeng Sumping, yeah, or like welcome. So in Sundanese, you can try to say it, Wilujeng Sumping. Yeah. So that's mean welcome. And Kampung actually mean village. So that's why it's called Cirende, Kampung Cirende, that's mean Cirende village. Yeah, so when you enter this gate, then you will go to this, it's like a hall kind of the village. And actually Bu Neneng, if you can see Bu Neneng right now, I think she's somewhere in front of this place. Yeah, that's why in the background you can see some kind of bamboo. Yeah, over her, and this is angklung, actually one of the musical traditional music that they play there. So if you visit Cirende one day, so we'll make sure that you get to play this kind of traditional music. And this is just a brief intro of who we are. So we are Wanderlust Indonesia, and we provide community-based tourism and sustainable tourism practices in Indonesia. And we started with trip, yeah, but then the pandemic hit us, yeah, hit the tourism badly. So then we have to pivot a bit. So we create several products for our clients, for the company, to be able to give, yeah, to their community. And we use the local product from the community, and you will get to know what are the products later also. It's too bad that you cannot taste it directly, yeah, because they have quite a lot of various food, yeah, delicious food, and they're very famous with that cassava, yeah. So here are our guide today that will be with you until the end of the session. So we have Teh Fitria here. Hello Teh Fitria, can you show where you are right now?
Hi, hello everyone. I'm Fitria.
Yes. Nice, hello, Teh Fitria. So guys, it's great to have you again here. Yeah. So Teh Fitria is a wonderful guide. So when you come to Cirende, you can ask her to accompany you. Yeah. To visit Cirende, she will take you not only in Cirende but all over Bandung. And then we have Kang Jajat. Hello, Kang Jajat. Sampurasun.
Hello, Sampurasun. Rampese.
Yeah, Kang. So Kang Jajat is one of the I can say a local champion from Cirende, because he is the coordinator for the tourism organization in Cirende. So he's one of the pioneer and also the organizer of all the tourism activity in this village. Yeah. So we are very happy to have you, Kang Jajat. Hatur nuhun sudah berada di sini ya, Kang ya. And then we have Bu Neneng. Hello, Bu Neneng. Sampurasun, Bu Neneng. Kayaknya masih mute, Bu Neneng. Yeah. And Bu Neneng is also another champion. I can say a woman champion. If Kang Jajat is the male champion, yeah, Bu Neneng is the woman champion. Why I say that? Because she's the founder and also the coordinator for this cool initiative. It's called Serba Singkong. In English, it's something like everything is cassava, something like that, because she transformed cassava into so many delicious food. Yeah, so not only cassava rice, but also a lot of snacks and a lot of various diversity. So we can taste it directly when you visit Cirende, and they also sell it in their store, yeah, local store there in a tourism center. And she lead the other woman community who also produce a lot of product with cassava. So hatur nuhun Bu Neneng sudah di sini. Nanti Bu Neneng bawa produk-produknya mungkin?
Iya,
So she the product with her, so then she will show you later what product that she actually has. And so just for to make it fun, yeah. So if you have something to share in your Instagram, you can tag us @iroitb and @itb1920 with the hashtag Cirende Virtual Tour. Yeah, so we see how you experience this. You can use Insta story or your Instagram feed, yeah, and so forth. Okay, I think that's from me, and I think the next will be some intro from Mr. Andika. Will you do it again, Pak Andika, or you already do it in the beginning?
I think I did it in the beginning,
yes.
But right. I would welcome again everybody. Uh-huh. Yeah, feel free to have a chat, and we're very excited for the session. Hopefully, everyone's going to enjoy the session, the virtual tour to Cirende village.
Yes.
That would be all from me.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Andika. And also, if you have any questions, yeah, we will have a Q&A session later, but you can also use the chat column to type your question or just to comment, yeah, on what you see here. And if anything, you can just the chat column to for the interaction. Yeah.
Great.
All right. I think without further ado, I will give the time right now for Teh Fitria to lead the virtual tour. Welcome, everyone.
Okay, hello everyone. Sampurasun. This is the greeting away of Sundanese. Maybe it sounds strange to you. Sampurasun means I'm sorry. This is how polite we are to everyone. So I'm sorry, and you will say rampes. Rampes is the way you answer. It's okay. This is how we communicate with the greeting. And then I will share some screen to you guys. So let me introduce myself first. My name is Fitria. Actually, I'm working as a tour guide for since 2016. So it's been already 6 years, and during the pandemic, I've been virtual tour guide. So here we are. Let's go. We are going to Bandung. For your information, I have to screen here, so I will share it over here, and then let's go. Imagine that we are in the airport. Right now, I'm sure you guys already know where we are going right now. So we are going to Kampung Adat Cirende. Cirende actually, I can say it's a small city compared to Bandung. If you never visit Indonesia before, we have 5 big islands, and then one of the most famous one is Java Island. In Java Island, there's so many famous cities too, and one of the famous one is called Bandung City. So we are going to Bandung. After that, we are going straight to Cimahi. And then I want to make sure that your mind, your eyes, your soul are already traveling with me. So I'm presenting you the visualization of how is the feeling when you're excited going to the airplane, and then let's wait until we arrive to Bandung. Okay, let's see. It's about takeoff, right? You can see. Okay, actually Bandung is surrounded by the mountain. So when you arrive at Bandung, you will see the sky is so full of the mountain. Okay, get ready to landing in Bandung.
Thank you.
Okay, guys. I hope your mind, your eyes, your soul already in Bandung. Okay, now let's go to Cirende. I want to share to you that actually we arrived at Bandung over here, and now we are going to transfer to Cirende. Cirende, which is the city called Cimahi. This is the sister city of Bandung. It will take about 40 minutes by motorcycle to go to Kampung Adat Cirende. So let's go. Here we are. We are going to see how Kampung Adat Cirende looks like. Tedini, could you help me out to share the screen of how Kampung Adat Cirende looks like?
Can you guess where I am right now? Yes! I am in Kampung Adat Cirende. So today we're gonna meet Kang Jajat and we're gonna do some trekking and taste the local cuisine. So let's go! Kang Jajat! I meet local people and a special one. Let me introduce you to Kang Jajat.
Hello.
Hello, Kang, kenalin Kang ke kamera Kang.
Ya, sampurasun nepangkeun wastakang Kang Jajat, Kang sebagai warga adat Kampung Cirende.
Kang, pandemik gini apa kabar Kampung Cirende, Kang? Ada dampaknya enggak?
Kalau kabarnya sih buat warga baik lah, karena aktivitas di Cirende kan kebanyakan petani, maka beraktivitas seperti biasa. Tapi untuk ke para wisata, sudah 2 tahun ini ya kami juga kebagian dampaknya. Karena sudah tidak ada lagi pengunjung, tidak ada lagi yang booking paket. Dari mulai homestay, pemandu, seniman, semuanya juga kena dampak dari pandemi. Tapi di akhir-akhir sekarang, setelah PKM yang Jawa Bali sudah mulai agak longgar juga, setiap hari Minggu juga masih udah banyak sih banyak pengunjung yang emang datang ke Cirende, tapi mereka kan yang dicarinya hanya kuliner, paling hiking, puncak celang. Udah itu aja, jadi nggak ada yang booking paket.
Nggak ada, Kang.
Nggak ada, we.
Jadi ya udah, we.
Ya udah, saya nunggu apa? Nunggu ini ikutlah sama pelatih.
Yang terkenal di sini tuh ada puncak celang, ya?
Iya.
Kita sana yuk, Kang.
Boleh.
Sekarang? Ayo.
Ya sekarang.
Let's go, kalau gitu.
Tapi sebentar. Kebetulan kalau ke Puncak Salam itu kan ada aturan seradat. Yang pertama itu tidak boleh pakai alas kaki.
Alas kaki?
Jadi harus dilepas.
Oh gitu?
Iya, kalau mau ke Puncak Salam lepas dulu alas kakinya.
Jadi kita lepas barang-barang alas kaki ya? Ya. Let's go, Kak.
Ini situs Nima Sende. Di atas ada mata air, ada lingga, termasuk ada beberapa ornamen yang untuk keperluan ibadah warga Hindu. Karena kebetulan warga Hindu yang dari Cimahi terutama, terus dari Bandung dan Batu Jajar, ketika melakukan upacara mengasti ya di sini. Jadi Batu Jajar itu.
Kampung Adat Cirende preserve their forest and nature because the local people always keep the nature and its surrounding due to the traditional from their ancestors. That is why we still can see the rare trees that exist in Cirende. They put the barcode in the tree, and when the people scan it, we can get the information about the tree. This is such a great idea to educate tourists who visit Cirende.
Lubung-lubung baladahan yang luasnya sampai 20 hektar lah, kalau dari sini sampai ke ujungnya gitu. Ini dimanfaatkan oleh petani untuk menanam singkong.
Fungsinya masing-masing itu apa, Kang?
Kalau larangan, orang tua selalu bilang itu gentong bumi. Jadi gentong bumi itu tempat menyimpan air ketika musim hujan tidak berlebihan dan ketika musim kemarau tidak kekurangan. Jadi disimpan, diserap sama fungsi lubung itu. Terus keduanya, rumah tinggalnya ya sesatuan hewan-hewan tertentu yang tadi kenapa banyak hewan liar kemana-mana karena emang tempatnya rusak tempatanlah di sana makanya kalau di larangan itu jangankan kita boleh masuk lah kecuali ada harus upacara yang harus kita lakukan baru boleh masuk membalikan daun yang yang udah jatuh juga nggak boleh.
Nggak boleh.
Mengambil buahnya nggak boleh, mengambil bunganya nggak boleh. Itu mah bukan hak manusia. Karena manusia udah dikasih hak di dunia balarahan untuk bicara.
When we reach the top of the mountain, we find a lot of garbage that left by the tourists who hike or camp. Wow, we even find a bag of dirty clothes that they left near the tree. This is a very serious problem in Kampung Adat Cirende that caused by a lot of irresponsible tourists. Kang Jajat and the other community in Cirende feel very sad about this. Even though they already put messages in many places to tell people not to throw away their garbage when they enter the forest, there is always tourists who still throw the garbage in the forest.
Di sini tuh biasanya orang-orang ngapain, Kang?
Biasanya kan sebenarnya kalau dulu di adat kita punya acara rutin lah setiap malam 17 Agustus itu ada acara ngeraja di puncak salam menyambut kemerdekaan.
Banyak sampah-sampah gini. Ini teh orang-orang yang iseng apa gimana ya, Kang?
Orang-orang yang tidak bertanggung jawab. Kalau mereka bertanggung jawab, suka main ke hutan, apalagi mengaku pencinta alam harusnya, ya sampah-sampahnya dibawa lagi dulu. Harusnya gitu sampah-sampah pelat itu bukan. Jadi bawa lagi dulu. Karena tidak punya rasa tanggung jawab, ya jadi seperti itu.
Jadi orang tua udah mau datang, nggak ada izin, tapi yang meninggalkan jejak berupa sampah gitu ya, Kang? Terus warga sini gimana, Kang? Pasrah aja tuh ya?
Sebenarnya kami aja yang dari Pokdarus aja yang suka gerget, bingung gitu kan, gerget. Makanya sebenarnya ketika orang masuk ketemu, Kang kan tidak memungut biaya untuk kesini. Maka silakan memainkan, yang penting sampahnya dibawa lagi. Itu aja, sampahnya dibawa lagi. Meskipun alat donasi berapapun kita terima, hanya untuk kebersihan aja. Gak yakin, meskipun kita terus himbau sampah-sampah dan sampah, tapi gak selalu aja sih.
Now, it's time to see how to make crazy with Kang Jajat.
Halo.
So this is how Kang Jajat and the community process the cassava. After that, we harvest the garden, they will put it inside the machine to grind the cassava into flour. We will leave the water in a night. This is an important step to produce high quality cassava. In order to make it dry, we have to make it small and dry it under the sun.
Jadi ini butuh waktu 2 hari untuk pengeringannya, jadi dijemur. Tunggu 2 hari sampai kering.
Wah, salah dipenang.
Yang kering.
Okay, everyone. So how to make rasi, as you already seen. And now it's time to make it like powder. So let's do it. And the process to make this to be rasi for the local people is about 4 hours, and for us maybe about 24 hours. So after you finish that process, make sure to be like this. Okay. Then the bigger part should be. Do the process again, and then until this part, you can make rasi, rasi with this. And for the flavor, from the cassava, you can make it from this one. After this, we will see how the women community making cireng, fried cassava flour filled with onion leaves. We will join her, Ibu, Mother Indonesia, to make this cassava best product. In their micro, small, medium enterprises called Serba Singkong. In English, everything is cassava.
Oh, ini cireng. Bahannya apa aja, Bu, ini teh?
Bahannya ada singkong, bawang putih, ada cassava, pedas, lada.
Jadi ini teh tinggal digoreng jadi cireng, Bu?
Iya, cireng.
Bu, selain cireng,
ya Bu ya? Itu salah satu yang terkenalnya tuh ada nasi goreng ya Bu ya?
Iya, kalau nasi goreng itu hari Minggu aja.
Now, let's join the Sunday vibes in Kampung Adat Cirende. The only day in the week that is full of people coming to Cirende. During the pandemic, the people who visit Cirende is not that much as usual. And there are not a lot of people join the tour or buy the products. This is one of the best-seller food that only exists every Sunday. Nasi goreng, fried cassava rice. So they use the cassava rice, replace the original rice, and fry it with the special spices. It smells so good. It also hard to get this as this nasi goreng sold out so quickly. We have to wait in line to order this. But when we test it, we know why it's best seller. It is super delicious.
Finally, got this nasi goreng. Jajajam. So if you thought that buying nasi goreng here, just order and you will get what you want, it's wrong. Because you need extra effort to get this one. You need to keep waiting behind the mother who cook the nasi goreng, and you still, so to say, I ordered this one, and you will get it at the end. So how is it? Let's taste. Nasi goreng. Hmm. It's a new taste for me. It doesn't really taste like rice, but somehow similar. Hmm. You should try this one. Hmm. For sure.
That's all our wonderful day at Kampung Cirende. We go to hike the forest and see the Maki cassava rice and flour with Kang Jajan. We also have a chance to eat delicious food and see the making process with Bu Neneng and the women community. It was a lovely day. Thank you for joining our trip and see you in the next trip.
Okay guys, how do you think about Kampung Adat Cirende? It's so interesting, right? Oh my god. For your information, at first Kampung Adat Cirende, at first this place is called Leuwi Gajah Area, and it's quite famous for Bandung people as one of lifestyle or the main garbage dump of Bandung. So each of us are producing the garbage, right? And then how Bandung manage the garbage of the village is they transfer it to another city, and they make it burn or something like that in the lifestyle. And then this place actually near to Kampung Adat Cirende. So the garbage that Bandung people have usually been there, damaged the weather actually. And could you even imagine how is the weather in Kampung Adat Cirende at first when they are really close to the lifestyle area? It's really smelly and not really comfortable, but people in Kampung Adat Cirende way, in my opinion, way too patient with everything. So they just let it go until at the end it's already changed the place. So the weather right now is already good. And one thing you need to know about Kampung Adat Cirende, as it's already mentioned, Kampung Adat Cirende actually special because usually Indonesian people like me, like you, I'm not sure how many Indonesian people are here, but we are tend to be like we claim that we are not having breakfast or not having lunch or not having dinner yet without consuming rice. Because rice is our main dish. Okay, without consuming rice, we are going to claim that we are not having a dinner or having breakfast or having meals. So if you are, for example, I see Majid Himat from Afghanistan. Okay, let's say Mr. Majid Himat, you are serving me some breakfast, for example, let's say sandwich with the soup with a bowl of soup, with the what is it, with the bowl of salad, and then I already eat that one, and then I will say I'm not eating yet because you're not serving me the rice. That's how Indonesian thinking in general. But Kampung Adat Cirende people are way too different. They are commit to not consuming rice based on some historical, and this is quite long if I give you the history why they are choosing not to consuming the rice, but instead they are choosing to consuming the terasi. We call it terasi or cassava based rice. And then after this, we are going to see Serba Singkong video, right, Tedini?
Yes, we're going to see one of the food that they make based on cassava.
Yes, you should see this one. Okay, let's see this one. Okay, so we have another video also from cassava. So could you even imagine cassava, and then you make it into the beef. And then another one things is we have this one.
Pakai telur 11 butir. Oke, pakai telur sama tepungnya 400 gram, menteganya 500 gram.
Oke, terus gimana cara buatnya?
Telur dulu ya.
Kita pecahin telurnya dulu sih. Ini teh biar bisa jadi berapa banyak? Ini biasanya berapa bungkus teh?
Habis ini, dikocok kurang lebih 10 menit.
Oke.
Okay, so you already seen the beef, or we call it dendeng actually, D-E-N-G. We call it dendeng. Dendeng is the fried beef. So when you taste the fried beef based on cassava, you will think like, how could it be based on cassava? Well, it really tastes like a real beef in a fried way. At first, I was surprised too. Later on, I will be like, okay, I will eat it this one, and it's so tasty one. And then the second one that we are recommend to you to taste is egg roll. Yeah, I believe you already taste the egg roll, right? And as you already seen, everything actually, I'm really glad to meet these genius people who invented the cassava based product to many kind of things that traditionally we are not using cassava on it, but they make it based on cassava. That's the best thing actually. And so, you know, today I'm not going to be alone. I'm going to have the local guide and the local genius with us today. So get ready. But one thing that you should know, actually, after the session, we are going to have discussion with the local guide and the local genius. We call it the local guide as Kang Jajat and the local genius as Teh Neneng. Kang Jajat, Kang is the way how you address someone older than you, usually for men. And Teh Neneng, Teh is how you address the older women. So Kang Jajat and Teh Neneng are already here with us. For your information, actually, they can speak English very well. So if you, they speak Sundanese very well. So actually Indonesian are, we are bilingual. We speak our local languages and we speak Bahasa Indonesia as our national languages. And we are with Teh Neneng and Kang Jajat who are fluent in the local languages called Sundanese. So I'm going to talk in Bahasa Indonesia so they will understand and you will see the translation through the chat section. Okay, guys. So I believe that you are really curious about a couple of things and you can drop your question on the chat section. So I will ask it directly to Teh Neneng and Kang Jajat. I will greet them first. Hello, Teh Neneng, Kang Jajat.
Hello.
Hello, hello, hello.
Hello, hello, hello.
Okay. Sorry for the childish way.
Yeah. Gimana? Okay. Gimana, Teh?
Kang Jajat, jadi teman-teman butuh teman-teman butuh mungkin sekilas dari Kang Jajat soal kampung adat Cirende yang teman-teman wajib tahu nih. Ini teman-teman itu para mahasiswa ITB nih Kang, jadi mereka pastinya sangat tertarik juga dengan gimana sih pariwisata di kampung adat Cirende, gimana pergerakannya di sana, mungkin boleh diceritakan Kang?
Ya, hatur nuhun, terima kasih. Suara saya jelas nggak, Teh?
Yes, jelas.
Oke. Ya, sekali lagi terima kasih Sampurasun, teman-teman yang telah hadir di dunia mana ya, dia? Di dunia yang tidak langsung kita ketemu di Cirende, tapi sedikitnya saya akan memperkenalkan seperti apa sih kampung Cirende. Cirende itu diambil dari Ci sama rende gitu. Kalau istilah Sunda itu ci itu cai, cai itu air ya, air dan rende itu adalah jenis tumbuhan atau pohon yang konon katanya banyak tumbuh di mata air yang berada di kampung adat Cirende. Makanya dinamakanlah kampung ini Cirende. Dan ada beberapa informasi yang saya terima dari sepuh bahwa selain diambil dari kata Cidang Rinde, bahwa Cirende itu asal dari Sarinde, Saigel, Sabobo, Capihanean, dalam arti gotong royong. Jadi Cirende itu diambil dari gotong royong masyarakat, yang bentuknya sebuah kampung yang sampai saat ini bertahan dengan masyarakat hukum adatnya. Nah, sebagai masyarakat hukum adat, tentunya ada beberapa nilai-nilai tradisi yang diwariskan oleh leluhur, antaranya ada budaya tuang sampe atau dikenal dengan ketahanan tangan dan singkong sebagai makanan pokok buat masyarakat adat kampung Cirende. Terus adanya tata wilayah, di mana kami diwarisi sebuah tata wilayah tentang pembagian hutan, di mana hutan itu terdiri dari tiga wilayah, yaitu adanya hutan larangan, hutan tutupan, dan hutan baladahan. Terus juga di sini itu masih menggelar berbagai upacara adat yang selalu dinanti oleh masyarakat Cirende itu adalah upacara adat tutup tahun, ngemban tahun Saka Sunda, atau dikenal dengan suraan, atau pesta panennya masyarakat adat kampung Cirende. Terus adanya upacara adat pernikahan, kelahiran, dan kematian, itu semua masih dikemas dalam berbagai ritual adat yang sampai saat ini kami jaga dan pertahankan. Mungkin Teh Fitri, apakah boleh terjemahkan dulu? Takut saya panjang.
Yes, already. Iya, Kang. Okay. Guys, Kang Jaja told us simply how what is the meaning of Kampung Adat Cirende? The main place is called Cirende, as is already written here. In Java Island, almost every place is always started with the Chi. C and I, it's mean water. So it has a long story, but yeah, at first we are full of water. So the basic is like that, Chi. And Rende, it has two versions. Actually, the first version is the name of the plant. So usually in West Java area or in Java generally, when you want to name the place, they name it based on what they see in West Java usually. They see or they hear about that thing. And this place back then was surrounded by Rende. Rende is the name of the plant. So it's called Chi Rende. And then another version, Rende, it's what is it? Rende, it's a gotong royong. Gotong royong, it's a way of our culture Indonesian love to helping each other. Helping each other in the same time in a group, it's called gotong royong, to solve something. So that's why Kampung Adat Cirende called Cirende. And then Kampung Adat Cirende has a lot of rules actually, and they divided the forest into three parts. The first part is you can visit that part, so it's open to everyone. The second part, this is only for harvesting something. So when you are harvesting the corn or harvesting the cassava, it's only available in the second area. And the third one is, we call it hutan tutupan. Tutupan means closed, the closed forest. It's actually forbidden to visit for anyone. So it's actually have a really, really complicated philosophy. It's not really complicated. It's just, I'm not really mastering it all. But I found it's really interesting to explore about that one. So that's the translation. And then before we talk further with Kang Jajat, we also have Teh Neneng here. Teh Neneng, hello.
Hello, kedengeran nggak?
Kedengeran, Teteh suaranya boleh naikin sedikit lagi? Duh. Cek.
Ya.
Oke. You know what? The Sundanese beauty is look like Teh Neneng. Teh Neneng has a bright skin, and then they speak very softly, not like me with rough one. And then Teh Neneng is so beautiful. So, Teh Neneng, mungkin boleh diceritain Teh, gimana sih awal mulanya Teteh memulai si serba singkong ini, gimana ceritanya Teh?
Awalnya karena yang awalnya kedatangnya tamu-tamu yang ke Cirende itu, terus karena di Cirende itu terkenal dengan nasi, dengan singkongnya itu, jadi kita berinovasi untuk membuat oleh-oleh dari singkong.
Terus Teh?
Ya, dari singkong itu kita buat menjadi olahan yang pertama kali sekarang menjadi ada dendeng dari singkong, ada egg roll, ada sisi.
Puan Ojeg.
Terus
terus suaranya hilang gak teh?
Banyak.
Iya.
Begitu. Jadi banyak ya olah-olahannya itu. Jadi kita berinovasi terus untuk para pengunjung yang datang di Cirende untuk mereka membawa oleh-oleh gitu. Jadi tidak hanya main di Cirende terus pulang dan tidak bawa apa-apa. Nah, dari itu kita membuat oleh-oleh itu buat pengunjung yang datang di Cirende gitu.
Okay, so I'm trying to translate this one. Teh Neneng said, I'm asking, how is the story of Serba Singkong made? Because it's rare to find. Actually, Serba Singkong it's filled with 10 mothers. You know, in Indonesia, they are living as the wife, but they are do the entrepreneurship, which is it's really cool in Kampung Adat Cirende. And Bu Neneng told us at first they are there's so many tourists that come to Kampung Adat Cirende and they want to innovate how to make something that everyone can buy, because as Indonesian, when we are traveling to some area, we tend to love to buy something to present it to our college or our family. We call it as buah tangan. It's maybe strange if I translate it. Buah tangan in English would be the fruit of hand. If I translate it roughly, it's the fruit of hand. It means that when you're traveling to somewhere as Indonesian, you need to bring something to your family or to your friends. Because of that kind of culture, Teh Neneng and friends try to invent the product of cassava. So starting from rasi, they starting to have the egg roll, the simping, and so many things. So I think that's a good start. If you want to asking for more things that you are still puzzling out about Kampung Adat Cirende, because it's really cool place actually. If you can visit it directly, you will see how the traditional village is still existing with the value of still eating the rasi instead of nasi kind of. Okay, maybe someone want to ask some question, please raise your hand. I will help you out to translate it to Teh Neneng and Kang Jaja. Maybe anyone want to ask some question? I see. So I don't see any hands. Okay. Maybe I will ask the one who still turn on the video. Maybe Majid Hima, do you have something curious about Kampung Adat Cirende? You are meeting the local genius and the local guy.
Hello to everyone. Am I clear with my voice?
Yes, I can hear it.
Yeah, it was wonderful. Thank you for Henene and Kang Jajet. So thank you for sharing the ideas and all stuff that we hear. And you guys as well. Yeah, thank you. So it was wonderful. I have no question. Maybe someday I will go there. I will taste everything. So. Yeah.
Really, you don't have any question?
No, it was clear. Yes, yeah.
Okay, no, it was clear. It's okay. Then we'll ask another question for Kang Jajat and Teh Neneng. Okay, Kang Jajat, I will start from you. How is your feeling during the COVID-19 pandemic? The tourism there, is it still going, or maybe you have some difficulties about that one? I'll translate it, Kang Jajat. Boleh cerita nggak kalau misalnya di Cirende selama pandemi ini gimana turismnya? Ada kendala kah, Kang?
Ya, terima kasih. Mungkin kalau selama pandemi full yang waktu PPKM memang kita nutup sendiri gitu. Karena secara adat pun kami diamanatkan oleh leluhur bahwa kita ini harus turut dan tuhu karatu raja larang gian Artinya kita harus turut sama pemerintahan yang sah. Ketika ada himbauan dari pemerintah, baik berupa aturan atau himbauan lisan, bahwa wisata harus tutup, ya kita menutup juga. Tapi sebenarnya dampak dari ketika COVID itu emang kalau di para wisata, ya kita terasa lah. Terutama ibu-ibu yang biasa bikin olahan serba singkong, ya mereka juga tidak mendapatkan pemasukan gitu. Tapi secara keseluruhan masyarakat Cirende, ketika pandemik ya mereka beraktivitas lebih banyak di kebun, lebih banyak di ladang seperti itu aja gitu. Kalau di pariwisata ya semua juga pernah itu masuk Cirende, terutama seniman. Seniman itu kan selain mereka biasa tampil ketika ada pengunjung ataupun ada hajatan mereka bisa tampil, tapi selama COVID itu ya nggak ada yang bisa tampil seperti itu. Tapi saat ini kan sekarang udah mulai longgar, udah ada yang masuk juga, termasuk kemarin juga kita baru menerima mahasiswa UNJ 40 orang yang semalam udah bisa terima juga. Itu teh.
Mantap Enggajat. Kalau Teh Neneng mungkin selama pandemi ini gimana teh keadaan serba singkongnya? Apalagi menurun kah atau tantangannya seperti apa teh?
Untuk selama pandemi kita emang tidak sama karena dari pemerintah juga kita harus tutup. Nah, sekarang kita udah mulai lagi. Dan mulai buka lagi itu terutama di hari Minggu. Hari Minggu kita buka untuk makanan kayak nasi singkong, tuwul, abus, dan kayak gitu. Nah, untuk kue-kuenya juga sekarang udah mulai lagi. Jadi banyak pengunjung yang datang ke sini. Kita cukup.
Oke, Teh. Okay, nice. Kang Gadget, do I still have you here? So the problem is like the signalist is the challenges one. Okay, Kang Gadget maybe still away from here. Teh Neneng, could you maybe... Teh Neneng, mungkin boleh cerita apa sih yang memotivasi para ibu-ibu buat berkreasi teh? Biasanya kan pada lebih senangnya di rumah gitu. Ternyata ini Teh Neneng dan 10 orang ibu-ibu ini aktif banget hampir setiap hari ya teh ya, produksi berbagai macamnya. Gimana sih teh? Ceritain dong teh.
Ya, pernah mungkin banyak pengunjung yang datang ke sini gitu. Jadi kasihan juga. Nggak ada yang jadi kita berinovasi untuk membuat oleh-oleh itu gitu. Terus ada juga sih masukan buat kita gitu, selain jadi ibu rumah tangga kita juga punya penghasilan meskipun cuma sedikit. Terus kita juga punya tas buat masukan, buat pemasukan di kampung Cirende juga. Kita berusaha itu apa membuat kue itu hasilnya kita ada kas juga kita buat untuk kepentingan di kampung Cirende juga, sama buat pembangunan yang ada di Cirende.
Mantap teh. Okay. Maybe I can ask Kang Gadget. Kang Gadget, halo Kang Gadget.
Ya, gimana teh? Halo.
Halo, Kang Gadget.
Halo.
Kang, kalau misalnya mungkin boleh ceritain juga ya yang menarik dari Kampung Adat Cirende biar teman-teman pada abis pandemi ini langsung pada ke Kampung Adat Cirende mungkin, Kang?
Ya, halo, gimana?
Halo, Kang. Halo.
Ya.
Oke, Kang.
Ya, halo, Teh, gimana?
Mungkin boleh bantu ceritain nih, Kang. Yang ngabibita ini teman-teman biar pada datang ke Kampung Adat Cirende, Kang. Mungkin kenapa sih harus datang ke Kampung Adat Cirende, Kang? Biar mereka makin kabita nih. Ada teman-teman dari Afghanistan, ada dari Pakistan, ada dari Malaysia. Wah, oh, macam-macam. Hei, Kang, kita promosikan Kampung Adat Cirende. Coba, Kang, promosiin.
Gimana ya, kan bukan ahli promosi nih. Tapi sedikit cerita lah buat teman-teman, terutama kan wisata yang apa yang kita bangun ini adalah jenis pariwisata yang edukasi, yang mengedukasi semua orang yang datang. Kenangannya itu edukasi, mengingatkan semua tentang kondisi alam saat ini. Gitu. Saya sering bercerita kepada beberapa orang yang datang, terutama mahasiswa, bahwa masa depan kita hari ini adalah semesta. Ketika semestanya tidak dijaga, apapun nanti bentuknya, kekayaan kita atau kalau istilah orang tua itu, Mas Berlian tidak akan ada harganya. ketika semesta ini rusak. Tadi kita mempunyai wilayah tentang lubung lara nanti depan balada hal seperti apa sih fungsi dari lubung itu. Terus keduanya ketahanan pangan, bahwa pangan itu atau makanan itu bukan hanya beras.
Gadget, are you here? I think Kang Jajat lost the connection. So we're gonna move to Teh Neneng. This is challenging. Teh Neneng. Halo Teh.
Ya, ini lumayan agak kurang bagus gitu. Ya. Ya.
Siap Teh.
Halo.
Halo. Oke, okay, Teh Neneng sebentar ya. Kang Jajat tadi belum selesai. Kang, gimana Kang? Ha?
Ya, gimana sih? Halo?
Halo? Oke, Kang. Lanjutin, Kang. Ya.
Sampai mana tadi ya? Tadi kepotong dulu.
Tadi itu, Kang.
Jadi, inilah edukasi yang kita tawarkan kepada pengunjung adalah tentang bagaimana konsep adat itu mengelola atau menjaga hutan. Karena hutan sebagai masa depan kita semua. Ada semesta inilah. Seperti itu. Terus keduanya juga mengingatkan semua bahwa sumber pangan itu tidak hanya beras, masih. Nah, kami punya hampir 100 tahun lebih masyarakat Cirebon tidak lagi mengkonsumsi beras sebagai makanan pokok. Tetapi menjadikan singkong sebagai makanan pokok sekaligus sumber ekonomi. Jadi orang datang ke Cirebon, kita kenalkan seperti apa sih singkong ini bisa menghidupi masyarakat adat kampung Cirebon sampai sekarang. Selain itu kebutuhan pokok, tadi juga sumber ekonomi. Jadi terus kita juga ajak jalan-jalan seperti apa di sana, di mana tata ruang kami masyarakat sini itu masyarakat adat yang istilahnya itu di muka waktu di bapak kajaman. Meskipun kami warga adat, tetapi perkembangan zaman teknologi kita tidak menolaknya. Hal seperti itu. Tetapi bagaimana mengupayakan agar sebenarnya bisa dijaga warisan leluhur tentang budaya adat pun kita tetap kita jaga juga. Gitu. Nah, jadi bagi teman-teman dari manapun yang ingin tahu seperti apa konsep karun kami dalam menjaga kewilayahan ini, dalam menjaga kesenian dan sebagainya, terutama ketahanan pangannya, yuk mangga kita main, kita belajar bareng-bareng, sama-sama kita belajar.
Mantap Kang. Okay, so every ethnic are different, every ethnic are unique, and Kampung Adat Cirende actually they are still make sure the Sundanese ethnic value are living with their present life. Because to be honest, even though I'm a Sundanese as well, I lack of the root. I miss a lot of the value because I'm way too modern, I guess. So if you are coming to Kampung Adat Cirende, wow, you will find the artistic things about living life as a Sundanese. Okay, then I will asking the Teh Neneng for another things. Teh Neneng. Hello? Teh, selama ini kalau misalnya teteh produksi serba singkong itu mungkin boleh dijelasin awal-awal alur sampai penjualannya itu kayak gimana teh? Mungkin dari singkongnya kah? Ambil dari mana, mungkin udah gitu sampai penjualan itu seperti apa, mungkin boleh ceritain teh, biar teman-teman pada tahu juga.
Jadi kita singkongnya dari petani, kita ngambil dari petani juga, terus kita giling sampai halus, udah gitu pengolahannya mungkin ya, seperti tadi yang udah dilihat di video kan, ada, nah, terus kita untuk bahan-bahannya kita beli di pasar juga gitu. Terus untuk bahan-bahannya dari petani, seperti biasa penjualannya kita hanya di Cirebon saja. Dan untuk ada yang online juga ada yang itu dari via WA. ya WA aja gitu. Jadi pemasarannya kebanyakannya di sini aja gitu. Jadi jualannya khusus di Kampung Cirende aja gitu.
Wah, menarik ya Teh. Jadi Teteh bisa bilang meskipun dijual di dalam Cirende itu udah sangat menghidupi banyak orang ya Teh ya, karena banyak orang yang terlibat di bisnis serba Cirende ini ya nggak sih Teh?
Iya, ya lumayan mendapatkan untungnya lumayan lah.
Gak usah ya Teh, gak usah dijual keluar, di dalam aja udah cukup ya Teh ya?
Iya, biar lebih tahu ke Cirende itu di mana gitu. Jadi mereka tahu Kampung Cirende dan mereka tahu oleh-oleh yang ada di Cirende. Seperti itu.
Oke, pokoknya biar orang-orang para datang beli langsung aja ya di Cirende. Mantap. Ya. Oke, then I will asking. Kang Jajat. Kang Jajat, if our friends go to Kampung Adat Cirende, what kind of activities do we will have there? Kang Jajat. Kalau misalnya kita ke sana, Kampung Adat Cirende, itu teman-teman kira-kira bisa diajak ngapain aja nih Kang di sana? Halo Kang.
Cirende. Iya. Banyak hal ya. Halo, halo. Ada. Ya.
Ada Kang.
Bagi teman-teman yang ingin bermain ke Cirende, banyak hal yang mungkin dilakukan gitu, terutama bagaimana mengenal masyarakat, budaya masyarakat sekitar, terutama Kampung Adat Cirende itu sendiri, dalam bentuk sosialnya, dalam kearifan lokal yang selama ini kami jaga. Kami pun tidak sungkan-sungkan memberikan informasi atau tidak lebar-lebar lah ngasih informasi kepada tamu yang berkunjung bagi pada pengolah singkong, bagaimana cara bertani singkong sampai sekarang ini terus turun temurun di Kampung Adat Cirende. Nah, dan ada hal yang baru juga mungkin. Kita sekarang lagi mempersiapkan satu kawasan sebagai tempat camping ground. Jadi bisa camping di sana, tetapi tetap aturan adatnya berlaku. Jadi masuk ke wilayah camping juga bukan berarti seperti camping-camping tempat lain. Jadi tetap aturan adat diberlakukan kalau misalkan melakukan aktivitas atau kegiatan di sana. Ya itu mungkin kalau misalkan bagi yang mau, ya manggalah bisa langsung main ke Cirende, gratis kok main ke Cirende. Kecuali kalau ada kegiatan ya kita tinggal punya paketnya.
So basically if you want to visit Kampung
Adat. Kalau cuma main jalan-jalan mah, yuk ya antar lah.
Yeah. So basically, if you want to visit Kampung Adat Cirende, there is no ticketing things because you are going to visit an original place, a village, a living village, where you can explore all the Sundanese fellow things with Kang Jajat and the friends. And also we have Teh Neneng here. Teh Neneng, aku mau nanya lagi.
Yeah.
Teh, kalau selama ini gimana sih cara para ibu-ibu untuk meningkatkan skillnya secara gitu ya Teh, awalnya kan bikin rasi tuh kerjaannya laki-laki kan Teh awalnya, mungkin perempuan awal-awalnya nggak pegang-pegang apapun, mungkin kesini-sini gimana sih cara teman-teman yang lain tuh pada punya skill untuk mengolah makanan yang enak dari kasava ini Teh, makanya produknya banyak-banyak ini?
Itu kita otodidak ya, kita coba-coba pertamanya. Kalau awalnya emang ada pelatihan juga ya dari universitas-universitas yang datang ke Cirende gitu. Terus sekarang kita punya produk yang lumayan banyak itu dari hasil coba-coba ibu-ibu yang sekarang ini gitu.
Oh, berarti Teteh sama teman-teman tuh punya waktu buat coba-coba masak ini gitu ya. Cobain ke yang lain gitu Teh.
Ya, seperti itu.
Oke. Teh, selama ini produk yang paling laris manis apa Teh kalau misalnya disebutin? Yang paling laris. Cepat banget
kejol. Laris itu egg roll sama dendeng kulit singkong.
Oke. Kalau menurut Teteh sendiri, kenapa sih egg roll sama si kulit singkongnya itu paling laris Teh?
Karena mungkin egg roll itu lebih empuk ya daripada terigu gitu. Karena ini dari singkong. Terus untuk dendeng juga, dendeng mungkin nggak ada di mana-mana ya, dendeng dari Pulau Singkong baru ada di sini gitu. Dan rasanya seperti dendeng katanya.
Seperti dendeng. Iya, teh enak banget ya. Kayak ditipu padahal enggak. Oke, oke. Okay. Nah, teh kalau misalnya kulit singkong nih, dendeng kulit singkong ini cuma ada di Cirende, enggak lebar teh, cuma dijual di sini aja. Enggak ingin gitu ngenalin ke tempat-tempat lain se-Indonesia mungkin. Ada mimpi-mimpi kayak gitu enggak teh mungkin?
Untuk itu sih ada juga, cuman kita kan dari Cirende aja gitu udah abis-abis terus gitu, sama bahannya juga kan kita yang ada di Cirende gitu. Jadi khusus kalau petani yang panen, kita siapin apa si kulit-kulitnya itu direbus gitu. Jadi kalau kulitnya itu juga nggak semua kulit yang ini bisa gitu, soalnya kan kulitnya yang bagus juga yang kita pakai gitu.
Oke, mantap tuh ya. Sekarang aku mau nanya ke Kang Jajat. Kang Jajat, kalau selama ini gimana sih ya, cara teman?
Seperti itu, Teh.
Yes, siap, Teh. Kang Jajat, sekarang aku mau nanya Kang Jajat.
Ya, gimana?
Kang, kalau teman-teman Kampung Adat Cirende, gimana sih caranya ngepromosiin Kampung Adat Cirende-nya sendiri nih, Kang?
Selama ini kita... kita tidak pernah promosi ya, terus siapa yang promosiin di sana Cirende dan yang lainnya, tapi kita jarang untuk promosi seperti itu karena kan kebetulan Cirende juga kan pusat penelitian juga, jadi tempat penelitian mahasiswa yang sering ke Cirende ya, mungkin dari cerita mereka lah yang orang mengenal Cirende. Dan kalau saya boleh menambahkan tadi apa yang dipertanyakan ke Teh Neneng tentang kenapa sih produknya dijual di dalam, itu juga bagian itu strateginya. Jadi produk kita sengaja kita jual orang biar datang, biar semua tahu. Kalau misalkan dijualnya keluar, nanti yang anggap dari segi keuntungannya, yang untung kan hanya ibu-ibu kelompok W aja sama petaninya. Bagaimana dengan pemandunya, bagaimana dengan senimannya, bagaimana dengan ini dan itunya. Nah, ketika orang datang ke Cirende, otomatis mereka pengen tahu. Ternyata kan bukan hanya produk makanannya yang ada di Cirende, tetapi ada yang lainnya. Mungkin orang datang ke Cirende bisa belajar seni, bisa belajar apa? Budaya masyarakat itu seperti apa. Apalagi kalau misalkan mereka yang datang nginep di Cirende benar-benar bisa merasakan bagaimana suasana Cirende dari mulai mereka datang sampai bisa menginap di sana, bagaimana keramahan masyarakat Sunda secara umum itu atau khususnya masyarakat adat Cirende. Nah itulah, kita ini nggak pernah sama sekali promosi, tapi kalau misalkan teman-teman baru yang mempromosikan Cirende, mungkin ada juga gitu. Tetapi yang selama ini strategi yang paling bagus adalah menahan produknya tetap di kampung. Biar orang datang. Ketika datang kan kita bercerita. Ini benar nggak dari dendeng kulit singkong? Ya benar. Seperti apa sih prosesnya? Ya proses seperti ini, tapi ada paketnya untuk bagaimana membuat dendeng kulit singkong. Akhirnya orang beli paket. Ya semua mulai hidup kan. Mulai pemandunya, termasuk mungkin petaninya. Gimana sih kebun singkongnya? Kan kita tunjukin gimana cara panen dan sebagainya. Itu yang kami lakukan saat ini. Dan itu sudah menjadi kesepakatan. Kesepakatan antara Pok Darwis dan para tokoh adat juga. Karena Cirende jadi tempat wisata itu tidak serta-merta keinginan kami. Tapi semua ada izinnya dari para sesepuh. Karena sekali lagi bahwa orang tua selalu mengingatkan bahwa warisan ini bukan untuk Kang Jajat. Warisan ini bukan untuk Teh Neneng. Tapi warisan ini untuk warga Cirende, khususnya warga adat, umumnya orang Cirende. Bagaimana pergerakan ekonomi ini bisa bergerak dengan para wisata. Ya, akhirnya kita lebih baik orang datang, nanti juga memancing ibu-ibu yang sekitar yang biasanya mereka mungkin pulang dari kebun cuma istirahat atau leha-leha, tapi setelah tahu bahwa setiap hari Minggu ataupun hari-hari tertentu banyak orang yang datang, akhirnya mendorong mereka untuk berinovasi. Sekarang itu produk-produk yang dari sini bukan hanya yang ada di Balai Adiah di bawah TNN yang, tetapi banyak kok ibu-ibu mungkin bikin kicimpring, bikin goodwill, bikin produk-produk dari singkong di rumahnya masing-masing. Dan bahkan minggu kemarin hari Minggu itu kan banyak tamu yang datang ke tempat jalan-jalan, ternyata ada beberapa orang yang udah mulai buka jualan-jualan produk dari singkong. Berarti kan sedikit-sedikit tumbuh ekonomi di Cirende. Nah itu teh yang kami lakukan. Jadi kalau untuk urusan promosi dan sebagainya, mungkin kita belum secara serius untuk mempromosikan karena banyak hal yang harus kita benahi terutama kesadaran masyarakat. Menyadarkan masyarakat itu tidak mudah, apalagi kapasitas saya atau kami Pokdaris juga belum bisa cukup, karena masih ada apa anggapan-anggapan dari masyarakat.
Jajat, are you frozen? Okay, I think we have already a lot of information about Kampung Adat Cirende, which is I will.
Yeah, itu aja.
You guys already want to go to Kampung Adat Cirende. Maybe I can asking the people over here because I see there is Malaysian friend here and Afghanistan, Pakistan, and okay, Mr. Majid Hima. Majid,
I want to add something. As Kang Jajet said that they don't want to have their products in the marketplace. So if the tourists do not know about their products, so how they can attack them directly to the Cirende? So maybe it's better to have the products in the marketplace somewhere in the big cities. So that the tourists have the taste of it, and then they can manage their tours to go to Kampung Adat Cirende. So maybe that's something to consider for them in the future, not because they said that they have problem in right now in the community as well, and the preservation of the product is something that they are thinking about. So it's better to have at least somehow, so I mean.
Okay, thank you so much. I will deliver it to Kang Jajat. Kang Jajat?
Iya. Yeah.
Kang Jajat katanya ya, apa nggak lebar nih? Ibaratnya kalau misalnya nggak ngikutin perkembangan zaman dengan masarin produknya di marketplace, itu orang-orang asing, itu gimana taunya gitu? Kalau selama ini nggak dipromosikan lewat beberapa channel yang udah populer gitu, Kang.
Maaf, bisa diulang. Tadi aku dengar.
Oke.
Bukan gitu. Oh, sebenarnya cuma ujungnya aja.
Populer. Oke, Kang. Jadi Kang, kata Kang Majid, kita itu gini. Kang, gimana orang-orang kayak kita tahu gitu kalau misalnya Kampung Adat Cirende produknya tidak dipromosikan lewat marketplace atau beberapa media yang banyak orang menggunain itu, Kang, apa enggak ngelebarkan gitu, Kang, gitu.
Iya, kalau ngobrol sama dia itu sayang lah. Produk itu sebenarnya cukup laris ya, terutama olahan singkongnya. Tetapi kan yang tadi kan kebersamaannya juga belum terbentuk. Terus keduanya kan kita juga memikirkan bahwa orang Cirende nanam singkong mengolah itu kan untuk kebutuhan pokok. Halo? Orang Cirende itu, kami itu bertani singkong. Ya, jadi itu sekali lagi ya bahwa saya sayang dengan produk ini kalau berbicaranya lebih ke apa ke bisnisnya gitu. Tetapi kami ini di adat ini kan masyarakat Cirende menanam singkong itu emang untuk kebutuhan pokok kami. Baru ada kelebihan produksi kita jual ke ibu-ibu untuk diolah menjadi oleh-olehnya seperti itu. Tapi kami juga tetap tidak bisa melanggar hal-hal lagi yang kami takutkan ketika emang pasarnya banyak, luas, dan membutuhkan bahan pokok yang cukup banyak juga, ada ketakutan teka wilayah kami jadi rusak. Teka wilayahnya jadi rusak ketika lahan baladahan sudah mampu lagi untuk ditanami singkong, ketakutannya ada petani-petani yang nanti menggarap lahan-lahan yang memang dilarang di adat. Nah, itu juga.
Okay. Halo. Okay, Mr. Majid, I will translate it for you. So, So they have the rules. They need to make everything as balanced as possible. Everyone want to explore, everyone want to promote it well, but they need to think about the stock of the staple food and the stock of the basic and the secondary needs they have. The basic is, the main rules is the cassava field over there and the hutan baladahan, or what I told you, they divide it into three forests. The first one, the forest you can visit. The second one is the forest you only plant everything you need over there. And the third one is the plant that you are forbidden to visit. And this second area of the forest is really limited. Well, the people who want to buy it, it's actually without promoting it, is already way too many people, so they cannot provide it actually. The plantation area is very limited, so they can provide it, and they tend to keep the commitment of making everything as balanced as possible, so they don't want to promote it outside. They just let it go. If you want to visit, just visit it from everywhere you will know, but they will not be promoting it because they're worried they cannot fulfill the request if it's too much, because it's already too much right now. So it's really popular now. From my experience,
already. Fitri, yeah. Can I add something?
Yes, sure.
Maybe to Majid. Yeah, actually, this is very interesting, yeah, Majid. I don't know if this has happened in your country or not, but we found that Cirende as the community, it's very unique. Like, not all community, once they attracted by tourists, like they want to get a lot of tourists come, right? They want to get a lot of income and make a lot of money from it. But Cirende is different. Like, we feel that they know that their village has the potential, but they really want to keep it, and preserve it as the village that this is their home. They don't want their home full of tourists, you know, come. And this has happened actually every weekend. They started to feel afraid of a lot of people will kind of invade their home or their forest. So the important thing is that cassava is our staple food. So that's why, somehow in the business perspective, when I come there also, like, I am in your mindset also. Like, I tell Buneneng, like, Buneneng, why don't you sell this like to a marketplace or to many places, because this is very delicious. Like, everyone, when once they order to me, they always want more. That's why saya pesan terus ya ke Buneneng ya. jadi sering WhatsApp Buneneng gitu, because a lot of people ask me to reorder. But Buneneng actually still have problem in logistics, so they very hard to reach like the closest like post office or delivery service. So that's why the thing that normally we did in Wanderlust also, we help them to kind of we restock the product. So we send it from our office to our tourists who join the virtual tour, or to our network who want to buy the Cirende product. So I must say that this community is very unique, and it's very important actually that the community itself has the awareness to keep the and preserving their village or their value despite a lot of opportunity that they can get out there. Yeah, that's just.
Yeah, I got it. We also have a community here in Afghanistan that they have their own food. We call it local food. Yeah, so it's everywhere. Yeah, Kang Jajet and Tehnene, you have my word. Whenever I come there, I will come to yeah Kapunga Cirende to taste your foods.
Yeah. Thank you, Majid.
Kang Jajat, katanya Kang Majid mau datang ke Cirende. Nanti jangan lupa disambut ya.
Iya, tunggu kehadirannya.
Okay, I will wait for your come. Kang Majid, Kang Majid. Okay. Maybe the other people over here, maybe you want to share your experiences. Maybe there's tribe over there that's similar to Kampung Adat Cirende, which is they are not really profit-oriented. They are really value-oriented. Maybe from Pakistan or from Malaysia. Kak Syahrul Rizal, maybe you want to share, is there any tribe over there similar to Kampung Adat Cirende?
Can you hear my voice?
Yeah.
Sorry, my camera is not working well today.
It's okay.
Sorry. But after the I want to share my experience after the virtual tour of Kampung Adat. My English not so well. Can I speak Malay?
Okay. Oh, Malaysia, okay.
Saya cakap perlahan-lahan.
Gak apa, ngerti kok.
Sebab saya dulu pernah ke Indonesia, ke kampung Bintang Berkapur dulu. Sekarang saya belajar di universiti di Melaka. Dekat antara Selat Melaka. Betul, saya teringin juga nak pergi Indon, nak sambung, bukan sambung, macam pertukaran pelajar ke, macam exchange student lah.
Ya.
Yeah. Macam dalam 2 minggu ke, seminggu ke, that will be enough for me, I think. just like the Indonesian people at Indonesia.
Ya, yeah, sure. Datang. Kalau di sana, aku panggilnya pakai bahasa Sunda aja ya. Kang Syahrul. Kang Syahrul, kalau di sana ada suku-suku yang serupa dengan, apa tuh namanya, Cirende mungkin? Di Malaysia ada tribe maybe or
similar? My mother actually from Javanese, from Ulek. Dia separuh Malay, separuh Jawa.
Okay. Nice. Berarti udah berapa kali ke Indonesianya, Kang?
Baru 2 kali ya.
2 kali ya. Okay. Nanti mungkin bisa datang ke Bandung lagi nih, langsung meluncur ke Cirende. Penasaran nggak sih ke Cirende?
Apa?
Penasaran nggak ke Cirende? Do you want to go to Cirende?
Yes, absolutely
good. Okay, thank you, Kang Syahrul. We already have Afghanistan, we already have Malaysian. Now I'm wondering if maybe there is Philippines or Pakistan or Egypt. Oh my god, we have Egypt people. Do you guys have maybe want to share, is there any unique tribe in your country? So I will searching that one. We can show to each other. Nobody, are you sure? I guess.
Hi, good afternoon.
Hi, good afternoon, Mr. Yeah. Rian. I will call you in Sundanese way. Kang Rian. Hello, Kang Rian.
I apologize. No, I don't have a webcam. No, But hearing and listening to your presentation earlier, I was amazed, and I could say that the practices that you have, you know, are similar to ours, no? Because most of our cultures are also similar to you, no? So I appreciate, no, the presentation, and I hope someday I will be able, no, to see personally, no, the things and the places you showed earlier.
Yeah, I hope so.
Yeah, because in 2018 I think I was there in Makassar. So I visited the place, so I hope someday, no, I will be able, no, to visit Java.
Sure, in Sulawesi, Makassar is in Sulawesi. Sulawesi, yeah. Kind of good to see, and we are here kind of good with the people over here. Okay, thank you, Mr. Ryan.
Thank you so much.
Okay, then maybe we can move on to another section over here. Maybe you are curious, what is the product of Kampung Adat Cirebon that we've been already talking since Teh Neneng already here? Maybe Teh Dini, could you help us so we can give you the preview of the product that Kampung Adat Cirebon have. And for your information, you can also buy the product. We will send it the souvenir with the shipping system. So maybe if you are interested to try it directly, we can help you out to taste it. Cirende market from the Serba Singkong. Maybe we can go to the next slide. Okay, Kampung Adat Cirende, yeah, as we already talk, already have a lot of products. This is, you know what, in Bandung, in West Java, we only have two tastes, two kind of tastes. It's not about sweet or the salty one, it's about the tasty and the very tasty one. And this is the very tasty one, I can guarantee it to you, because I already spent my money quite a lot of things for snaking around, and oh my god. Okay, let's get cireng, and then we already have here, we have cireng kering bumbu pedas. Cireng kering bumbu pedas. This is actually a crisps, and then the taste is, there is a salty one and there is a spicy one, and then you can see it's really tight and good. And then the second one, this is only 25,000 rupiah, or maybe it's about, ini is about berapa dolar ya? $2.
Less than $2.
Yeah, less than $2. Could you even
imagine? Depends on the dollar, but it's around $2 to US dollar. Yeah.
To US dollar, yeah, around that one. You already have 130 gram of dendeng, which is, I told you, dendeng is the beef. You can eat it with the rice or you can eat it with the rasi. Again, next we have another bestseller things in Kampung Adat Cirende. It's called egg roll singkong. Egg roll singkong, it's actually from, the taste is quite light, and then there is many kind of variation over here. The original one, the cheese one, the what is it? Mm-mm, there's so many flavor over here, but the most bestseller one is the original one. You need to taste this one. It's all based on cassava. And then this is actually traditional hat of the men in Sundanese. We call it ikat Sunda. Ikat Sunda, this is, the style is, what is it? The Cirende style. So you can have it, the ikat Sunda, or the hat of the traditional, it's actually represent of your position in the village. And then it's only 4 dollar, right? Next we have rasi or beras singkong. This is what we already talking about. Maybe usually you see the rice field, we have the rice beras. And then here we have rasi. Rasi means beras singkong. Beras singkong means cassava rice. And then this is how it's looked like. Yeah, that's it. So you can explore many kind of things that we already talking about by buying that product. We can send it online. From Wanderlust, we will send it to your place. And then you can calling our Teh Dini, our Wanderlust team, to have that. Hey, Miss Nayira Subay from Egypt. I just saw your face. So beautiful. Hello.
Hello.
Hi. Maybe you can, are you interested to go to Cirende? Maybe any something you are interested to?
Yes. I wish to go there.
Oh, sure.
Hopefully.
Okay, then.
Because I love singkong.
You love singkong. You already know singkong. Kasam pa singkong. Oh, okay. What kind of product you already have from singkong? It's only raw singkong?
Kerupuk. Kerupuk. Singkong kerupuk.
Singkong
kerupuk.
Kerupuk.
Chips.
Kerupuk. Yeah. Oh, okay. I'm thinking, I'm sorry. Ah, singkong kerupuk. Okay. That's tasty too. Nice. And you can, maybe you are suitable for choosing cireng, kicimpring over there from singkong. Nice. Okay. So if you're in Indonesia and you are interested to buy, you can order in Cirende Market. Okay. If you're not, make sure you are come to Indonesia and you can order it.
Yeah.
Okay, good. Nah, then this is gonna be our last session. Make sure to fill in the feedback form. We'll send you the feedback form over here in the comment section. And maybe before we are closing our session, Mr. Andika or Ms. Dini, you want to add something? Well, people, our friends already filling the feedback form.
Yeah, I mean, for me, I think I have to say thank you first for Kang Jajat and Bu Neneng. Atur nuhun Kang Jajat, Bu Neneng sudah berkenan hadir ya dengan sinyal yang kadang on off ya. Tapi hari ini alhamdulillah lancar, jadi atur nuhun. So thank you for our local champion. Maybe we can give applause to them. Yeah, because no matter what, they trying to keep the signal ya on and speak in front of us. So it's been a real pleasure, and for all of you, especially the international students. I don't know if you're in Indonesia or you will come here next year. Yeah. So let us know. Yeah, let us know. We'll be happy to take you to Cirende or to places in Bandung. Yeah, you will enjoy this place hopefully. And I hope you can meet Kang Jajat and Bu Neneng directly and taste the rasi goreng. Yeah, the fried rice. And you better bring Teh Fitri, yeah, so then you can get exclusive seat, yeah, or special place, yeah, rather than getting there by yourself, for instance. But it's been a very great afternoon being here with all of you. Thank you, Pak Andika, also for arranging this. Thank you.
Okay, maybe Mr. Andika, you want to add something as a closing statement?
I have nothing else to add. I'm very happy that everybody seems to be enjoying the whole thing. Kang Jajat, Neneng, Pak Dini, Pak Fitria, and everybody who has been here. Yeah, we're just gonna, you know, leave it at the closing now. And there's this feedback as well. And we're looking forward to having you in Indonesia for a lot of you. Hopefully the process is going to be smooth, yeah, with all the hassles and everything, but we're hoping that things are you know, going very well. So I'm happy that the our session, our virtual tour has been going on very well, and that's it. thank you very much.
Okay, everyone. Thank you so much, Mr. Andika and Ms. Dini. Now, actually, gonna say thank you so much for your participation. I hope, guys, you are not really satisfied with what I'm explaining, or you are not really satisfied with what you heard, or what you saw, or what you feel about this tour, because I need you to feel that feeling, and you will need and you will urge to go to Bandung directly and to prove everything. Is it as is what we've been told you or not? So you need to prove it by yourself and come to Bandung for sure. I think that's all from me and from Wanderlust team. Thank you so much for joining our session. Make sure to
fill in the photo, Fitria.
And take a picture first. Okay, everyone, before we leaving our session, let's open up your camera if you have it, and then Let's take a picture. Indonesian style or ASEAN style? Okay, everyone.
Okay, I will count. 1, 2, 3. Ah, we have a little visitor with Miss Fatatus. Okay, the other one. Freestyle. 1, 2, 3. Okay, I got it.
Thank you so much, Miss Dini, for having me. Also, Mr. Andika, for having me. And thank you so much, guys, for having our blessed 2 hours together. I hope to see you soon in another session. And especially, I hope you guys come to Cirende and visit Kang Jajat, also Teh Neneng, to prove everything. Thank you so much. Bye-bye. I will post it with the video.
Oke, okay, Allah Hafiz. Sampai jumpa.
Hello everyone. Can you guess where I am right now? Yes, I am in Kampung Adat Cirende. So today we gonna meet Kang Jajat and we gonna do some trekking and taste the local cuisine. So let's go. I met a local people and a special one. Let me introduce you to Kang Jajat.
Hello.
Kang, kenalin Kang, ke kamera Kang.
Ya, sampurasun, nepangkeun wastakang Kang Jajat, Kang sebagai warga adat Kampung Cirende.
Kang, pandemik gini apa kabar Kampung Cirende, Kang? Ada dampaknya nggak?
Kalau kabarnya sih buat warga baik lah, karena aktivitas di Cirende kan kebanyakan petani, maka beraktivitas seperti biasa. Tapi untuk ke para wisata, sudah 2 tahun ini ya kami juga kebagian dampaknya. Karena sudah tidak ada lagi pengunjung, tidak ada lagi yang booking paket. Dari mulai homestay, pemandu, seniman, semuanya juga kena dampak dari pandemi. Tapi di akhir-akhir... Situs di Mas Ende. Kita boleh masuk ke
Kan Jajat. Okay everyone, so how to make rasi?
Kong, sinar bawang, bawang putih. Kamu Kan Jajat masak sama pedas, lada.
Jadi teteh tinggal digoreng jadi cireng, Bu?
Iya, cireng.
Bu, selain cireng teh, ada apa lagi produknya, Bu, dari singkong?
Itu ada intro.
It's a new taste for me. It doesn't really taste like rice, but somehow similar. You should try this one. For sure. That's all our wonderful day at Kampung Cirende. We go to hike the forest and see the making cassava rice and flour with Kang Jajat. We also have a chance to eat delicious food and see the making process with Bu Neneng and the women community. It was a lovely day. Thank you for joining our trip and see you in the next trip.
All right, thank you everyone. Thank you for participating. Thank you, Kang Jajat.
Thank you very much. Sampai
thank
jumpa.
Thank you for organizing. Sampai jumpa. Have a good time.
Have a good day. Bye. Thank you.
Ingin hijaumu sejukkan ku.
Jajat semua, terima kasih banyak.
Ya, ternuhun Kang Jajat. Ternuhun Kang Jajat lagi.
Ternuhun.
Mangga Kang Jajat.
Kang Tunura, Pak Yun.
Mangga.
Oh iya, Bu Neneng udah ini ya tadi ya. Oke, ya terima kasih Teh Fitri ya.
Iya, terima kasih banyak nih.
Terus tadi ini aku sempat nge-blank tadi ini orang ini ngomong apa
masih,
ya?
Masih live YouTube ini.
Oh, masih live?
Kita masih live YouTube, nggak apa-apa lah ya.
Hai, Abasi.
Hai, Abasi.
Hai.
Hai, are you in Tanzania right now?
Yes, in Tanzania right now.
Oh, I've been there in 2016 in Arusha. Is it Arusha?
But I am in Zanzibar.
Zanzibar.
Yeah, Okay. Hope to see you in Indonesia.
Okay, thank you.
January. Hopefully soon, yeah.
Hopefully soon.
Okay. Mm. The process is going well.
Okay.
Hopefully. Okay, see you all.
See you.
Bye.
Sampai jumpa.
Sampai jumpa, ya. Yeah.